ready to race? I'm ready when you are. See you on the other side. For winning the race. You earned it.
I think you owe me some answers.
Name's Atta. As for how we got these mounts, most of us here used to be rebels. Joined Regala's army thinking we'd get a chance to fight in a real war against the Karja. Instead, Regala slaughtered our own in cold blood, barren light. When we made it back to camp, we snuck out on our mounts and never looked back. Been racing the clan lands ever since. Decided we were better off on our own. No rules, no chiefs. Just the speed of our mounts and the taste of blood.
Doesn't sound too bad, I guess. Where's your quiet friend? The one with the mask. He didn't join the race.
He gave up his spot so you could join. Probably for the best.
What makes you say that?
That one hasn't lost a single race. Thought you would have gotten your answers if he stuck around.
Maybe.
You know, Hax found a spot to set up a race at the farthest end of Lowland Territory, right by the beach. Make your way there, maybe there'll be a spot waiting for you.
If I'm in the area, I'll think about it.
Hey, Loy, you here to join the race? We got a spot open if you want to race.
I have to head out.
It'll give this lot a chance to practice before our next race.
Man, give me some pointers! I run on instinct. Can't help it if mine's better than yours.
Catch a break from this heat.
good use of this. Shotgun would help. Pigment would work well on armor.
Squad went. You even think you'd get a fresh ink to come through?
What? Your spectators?
That's how good of a fight it was, my friend.
So the machines the rebels come from. How do they do it? Tame them to ride, that is.
Your guess is as good as mine.
Could you imagine what it feels like? Charging at an enemy, blade in hand? It must be something. I finally earned enough medals from the hunting grounds to trade the Duck Hunt. Good day.
You wanted to speak to me?
The name's Zocca. Have you heard from up north? From Bleeding Mark?
I'm guessing that's a place.
One of the desert's villages. They send their yield of ash blood so the Bereka over there can mark the skin of our soldiers. But it's been a long time since the last supply run. Too long.
If you think something happened to them, can't you send someone to go check?
Were it up to me. But with everyone fuming about our water rations, the commander can't spare any soldiers. My face paint will strike fear in your enemies. Take a look.
You mentioned the village up north sends some supplies to the capital. Ashblood?
It's a crimson stone that we grind into powder for our ink. Bleeding Mark has the largest supply. Our soldiers there gather and deliver it to us, in exchange for their water rations.
Die for water.
Everyone in the clan depends on the wound in the sand for their water. Capital and outlying village alike. But the last delivery of Ashblood was weeks ago. Our supply is running low. So must be their water.
If I'm out that way, I can look in on the village, find out what's the delay.
You have my thanks. Head north to a ruin where the desert meets the mountains. That's Bleeding Mark. Ask for Kentok or Natika there. They'll know what's going on.
Fine piece, if I say so myself.
Give less water.
These rations barely get us through the day, Commander.
Our children are thirsty.
Doesn't Command have reserves?
Exactly. I'll bet they're keeping the water for themselves.
Not a happy place.
Why put guards around the wound?
You can't just take away our water.
The wound gives less water. Our rations adjust. What's going on?
We know the way of the desert! What's stopping us from taking what we want and...
Anyone else want to complain? We're the Desert Clan. We survive with what we have.
Your, commander's not much for handholding.
That is not our way. Even less so in her case. shall we?
Sure. Can't wait.
She's with me.
Draka's not the only one with harsh words for your commander.
The desert has bred survival into our clan's blood. We spit at death and charge into battle. Maybe a little too eagerly.
So, this is the Outlander conspiring with the dissident Draka.
Demanding water does not make one a dissident, Yara.
Doesn't make Draka a commander either. You should advise him of that.
Jataka said you needed help.
Did he now?
Aloy has a unique insight into the ways of the Old Ones. She might be able to fix this before it gets out of hand.
Get to the point. What is Jataka talking about?
There is no water.
What do you mean?
I mean the wound in the sand, that which provides the clan with the water we need to survive, is completely dry.
This water source. Jataka said it's somehow related to the Old Ones?
From what we can tell, whatever water we take, it restores on its own. Over time. A few weeks ago, it stopped. I ordered rationing, searched for other viable sources. But everything else nearby is tainted one way or another.
But why the secrecy? Keeping your people in the dark seems to be making things worse.
If the clan knew, my command would be challenged.
There's no water, and you're worrying about keeping your command?
Think what you want. Between the machines, the storms, and Regala's uprising, I'm the only thing keeping this clan from falling apart.
Draka said your clan won't touch Regala.
Her grudge is with Chief Hakaro, not me. And I plan to keep it that way, so her troops don't turn on my clan. Besides, if she defeats Hakaro, she deserves to rule. That's the way of the tribe.
Draka's people sacrificed a lot to get that water. He thinks you're hoarding it for yourself.
The perfect excuse to challenge my command. Like he's always wanted. Of course he makes it sound very noble. That he only cares about his thirsty people. But all he really wants is to be in charge. And if he was, he'd face the exact same problem I have. There is simply not enough water to go around.
So how are you going to deal with not having any water?
Ration what little we have. Buy time to fix the wound.
And in the meantime, people die of thirst?
Every corpse weighs on me. That is what it means to be a commander. What matters is that the clan survives, as a whole.
I can't promise anything, but if this wound was built by the Old Ones, I might be able to fix it.
How exactly do you intend to do that?
Just show her the wound, Yara.
Very well. You can tell me when we get there.
After you.
The wound in the sand is this way.
Move, soldier, move!
You're not Karja, or Oseram.
I was born amongst the Nora. As far east as you are west.
I've heard of your people. They say only those who are exiled leave your lands.
There are exceptions.
What business does a Nora exception have in the west?
Believe it or not, to help people, even the ones who don't want it.
Sounds like a difficult path. This is it. The wound in the sand.
Definitely built by the Old Ones. Focus should show me more. Pipes. Leading outside the settlement.
What do you see?
Trail.
I doubt you'll find anything to fix the wound there. What are you doing?
Your wound leads underground.
We've tried going down there, but it's too narrow for anyone to reach the bottom. Where are you going?
I think that can lead us to where the water comes from. Or used to.
How?
Doesn't matter.
What matters is that the wound is fixed and my people survive. Lead the way.
Good day.
Doesn't look like plasma will do much damage.
Machines.
Those flowers. The ground's wet too. The vein must have leaked here. Not enough to be the cause of the missing water, but enough for these plants to grow. We're on the right track.
You see all that from a patch of wet sand?
Yep.
That mound. It looks like the metal from the wound. We really are following its trail.
As I've been saying,
the desert kills, but it also surprises.
I should check where the ships are headed with my focus. That goes past that ridge.
We're gonna have to do some climbing.
Nothing we can't handle, I'm sure.
You get a strong color in this. It's a lot of machines.
And a very dead soldier.
Is it one of yours?
I need to take a closer look.
We need to get rid of the machines first. Follow my lead. Hurry. inside for a while with this, so I should be able to use it now.
Hit it hard! Let's take it down!
You know him?
That is one of Draka's men. I will cut off that dissident's head and feed it to the vultures if he had anything to do with...
We don't know what happened here yet. And we still have a trail to follow.
Lead the way.
Water. Barely a lick's worth. But there are no streams in this area. These anchors. That soldier must have used them to get up this cliff.
He must have been going back to Arrowhand when those machines got him.
Maybe he found something up there worth reporting back about.
We'll find out soon enough. Save this green shine for something special.
What is this?
The problem. I'm gonna need this focus.
Do you see anything with that second sight of yours?
That weapon. Looks like Draka's man tried to pry this open. But he didn't know what he was doing. And now the water's not going where it's supposed to.
Sabotage.
Or ignorance. Don't think this is gonna do anything. Maybe if I follow that main pipe, I'll find something useful.
What do you need me to do?
Just, stay here. Let me know if anything changes. I'm gonna take a look around. The valve. That might help.
Hey! It stopped leaking.
It looks like that stopped the water flow. I just need to find a way to get it to Scalding Spear. That's the same type of machinery we found outside. Only this one's not leaking. Maybe it can help me switch the water flow. Gotta open the valve upstairs. Get that water circulating. Back. Couldn't hold the water pressure. I gotta get up to that valve faster. Sounds like the water switched. Gotta open the valve upstairs. Get that water circulating.
Sounds like that did something.
Aloy, I can hear water in the room again.
Anything leaking?
Not that I can see.
Let's hope that means my plan worked.
That should do it.
This will return water to Scalding Spear?
Checking the wound is the only way to be sure.
Draka knew what would happen if the capital was left without water. But he didn't care! All he wanted was to cause a crisis so he could challenge my command.
We don't know that for sure.
Meet me back at the wound when you can. Please. To make sure the water will flow.
I will. Don't do anything rash about Draka.
Only an upstart acts rashly.
A commander bides her time. Hey. The desert was kind to lead you to us.
Things are about to get ugly between Draka and Yara. Maybe I can head it off.
to follow up.
If what Jataka says is true, Yara and Draka will end up killing a lot more than just each other. There has to be something I can do. I see soldiers guarding the wound in the sand. But no Yara. What's going on? I need to see the wound.
I'm afraid your presence is required in the commander's quarters.
Is everything okay?
The dissident Draka has been apprehended for interfering with the wound.
How did he interfere?
He entered the wound by force, saw that it was empty, except for a slow trickle that began when you fixed the device in the desert. He did not take it well.
Of course he didn't. I'll go meet with them. The water's coming back, slowly. It'll take a while for it to be full, but at least it's something. And now Draka's seen it too. What's going on here?
Close combat training. Fighting at long range is a good strategy for machines. But fighting an enemy soldier means getting up in their face. I'm Lee Rocket. I run the training pit here in Scalding Spear. Only a few Outlanders have ever made it out this far west. But from what I've heard, you're a pretty good fighter. You can train here if you like, but you're only allowed your spear and a practice bow in the pit. Everything else stays with me. And if you're looking to test your fighting skills, I also offer challenges. Complete all of them, and you'll get to go up against me.
And what happens if I beat you?
I'll grant you a mark to prove you've mastered this training pit. If you earn marks from me and the pit masters of the Bulwark and Thornmarch, you'll earn the right to challenge the Enduring.
I think I've heard of the Enduring. Some kind of Tanakh trainer?
More than just a trainer. The Enduring is a legendary fighter among the clans. The master of masters. Only those who prove themselves in the pits get to train with the Enduring.
Including Outlanders?
Yes. If you can beat all the pitmasters. So, what will it be? Should you want to practice or take on a challenge, just let me know.
Combine single attacks, you can also chain combinations. Try it with this one. Different. I want you to practice using aerial slash to chain into an aerial shot.
That was a good fight. Pretty sure I'll have a bruise to remember it by. Here, a mark is promised.
Thanks. One down, I guess.
Go to the training pits in the Bulwark and Thornmarsh. Earn their marks, then you can challenge the Enduring. Few have ever done so, but I think you might have a shot. And if you want to train more or take on another challenge, let me know. The pit will always welcome you.
I'll be going.
Let me know if you want to train in the pit again. You've proven yourself, but training will help keep your edge. So how about it?
Another time, Liu Kei.
Very well then.
have some nerve.
You want to talk?
That doesn't sound good.
See that move there?
Watch your tone.
Or what? You'll let these two kill me?
I can't believe this.
Agreed. I can't believe you either.
Everything's sticking. Ugh, damn this heat.
How could you let this happen?
How did I let this happen? You're the one who sabotaged the wound in the first place. You're lucky we were able to fix it, or your head would already be on a spear.
You call that fixed? It's just a dribble. And it's not my fault. I already told you, Ukta came to me. He said he found something in the desert that might get us water. I had no idea it had anything to do with the wound.
And you expect me to believe that?
Aloy, I came for the water that was owed to us, and when I found out that there is no water, they arrested me.
As I already told you, the water is returning, but slowly. It'll be weeks before the wound is full again. Until then, I will send Arrowhand what I can.
You hid what happened to the wound. How can we believe you now?
Draka.
No, you know what? Enough of this! No more words! Consider that a challenge!
Gather your squads, then, and meet us at the Gate of the Vanquished. I have a challenge to prepare for. Leave me!
This will be the end of the clan. I have to stop it. We have to stop it.
Hold on a second. Help me understand. What do you mean, the end of the clan?
Both sides will take their most loyal squads to the Gate of the Vanquished. Then they'll butcher each other as part of a ritual challenge. But it won't stop there. Whoever wins will try to wipe out the loser's loyalists all over the desert. The fighting could last for months. Those two scab heads are going to doom us all.
Can't you stop them?
I'm a chaplain. I provide counsel. I cannot force them to heed it. Even Chief Akaro can't intervene. It is a matter for the clan alone.
What is this gate?
The doorway to a dead cauldron. A symbol of what the tribe aspires to. The defeat of deranged machines.
Dead? What shut it off?
No one knows, but it is a place of great significance for our clan. Even greater now, since it will mark the onslaught of a massacre.
What makes you think I can help you stop them? I'm not even from this tribe.
They both owe you a debt. You aided them when no one else could, and you've seen into their hearts, just like I have. Misguided in different ways, but no less worthy of the people they protect. Your words might be enough to spear some sense into them.
Yeah, well, they're not exactly good listeners.
And you are no ordinary speaker, especially with a bow in your hand. I will go to the Gate of the Vanquished, southwest of here, to stall them. But without you, I'm afraid we'll run out of body bags fast.